Good day everyone, I am Dr. Chasanal Rathod, a pediatric orthopedic surgeon practicing at SRCC Children's Hospital managed by Narayana Healthcare at Haji Ali, Mumbai. So today I will be talking about gait, that is walking problems in children. And being a pediatric ortho surgeon, the most common question I see every day in the clinic is my child walking right or is the child having any walking problems? And usually the parents, the grandparents or even the neighbors are very good at picking up walking problems in children. So let's see what are these common problems and how we can help you through these. So coming to the first one, that is my child has not yet started walking. So now the child is just 1 year old or maybe not even reached 1 year and parents have a little panic or concern that the child is not walking. It's completely normal that the child might walk till 18 months and there's nothing to worry about. However, certain red flags like a child born prematurely or having delayed milestones in the early 1 year could be a concern and would need a checkup in the hospital for this purpose. Second problem is maybe the child is walking on toes or the child has toes turning inwards, that is the foot is turning inwards. So when the child starts walking, they are usually playful and they try to run around on toes, and when they are walking slowly, they tend to keep the feet down. So this is like without a reason the child walking on the toes, which is called idiopathic toe walking. And over a period of time with some stretching and trying to break this habit, the child tends to walk normally. But however, again in neurological conditions like cerebral palsy or if the child has delayed milestones, then we have to be worried or cautious about the child walking on toes. Second would be the foot turning inside while walking, like the leg is being turned inward while walking. So that happens when the thigh bone or the leg bone, that is the femur or tibia, are turning inward. And these are again developmental problems. So kids are born with the thigh bone being turned inside and as they grow, this remodels till age 9. And it tends to become normal till age 9. So again, it's not a concern, but here concerning would be a child sitting in W position. W is something like a Vajrasana, which the kid tries to bend the knees and put behind and sit. So we should again try to break this habit and get the child sitting in a cross leg position or in a 90-90 degree position on a chair. And apart from this, we often see the parents have brought the child which the child is limping. So this limp can be a painful limp or a painless limp. So now limp could be due to various causes like congenital cause, which are by birth, or a metabolic cause or inflammation or maybe even infection. And the limp should not be taken lightly and it needs a very quick investigation for the cause why the child is limping. And basic tests like an X-ray or something advanced like an MRI or CT or a sonography helps us to find the reason for the limp and address it accordingly. And lastly, most of the time we see very complex walking patterns which child is walking very like having lot of deformities and is not walking well. So these are mainly seen with kids who have brain problems like neurological problems, spine problems like cerebral palsy, spina bifida, myelomeningocele. So these terms sound very big and like scary, but yes, these problems also come with a lot of gait problems, that is walking problems, and these patterns are quite complex patterns and they can be corrected to make the walking pattern near normal. And with stage surgeries or surgeries which are spanned out over some years of the child during his growing stage, and we can make this child walk nearly normal. So important is that the child tries to walk well and he doesn't remain behind to his peer group or friends, and we should try to have this child like playing when he is in his playing age group rather than just having him sit because he's having a difficult or a troublesome walking pattern. And we can certainly fix it through different investigations. Often parents ask that is there any way we could check for the walking pattern. So yes, we do have some tests which help us to understand the walking problems, which is called a gait analysis. So a gait analysis is usually performed in a gait lab, and we have some labs in Mumbai which we can guide you for to do this analysis, and they help us to pick up subtle problems or even complex problems of walking or gait, and we help you treat those. And lastly, to conclude, I would say that yes, walking problems are always a concern with growing child, because the child is growing each day and then the child tends to walk differently, and we should take this little seriously and with caution, and with some basic tests and some advanced tests we can always find the cause and treat it accordingly. So we look forward to help you solve any kids walking problems at SRCC Children's Hospital, managed by Narayana, and please feel free to get in touch with us. Thank you.